Hello community, I hope you are doing good. In this discussion we will see introduction part about the portal development in Odoo version 15 community version. And in case you missed previous discussion about how to translate email templates in different languages using Jinja2 template or using the QApp template engine. And in case you want to learn more about Odoo, you can visit the Weblens channel. Under the playlist you can see Odoo development label is here, and here you can see Odoo development different playlist available with the different topic wise with the real test cases. And in case you need any support related Odoo, you can visit the about page and send your query to this email address. Source code also available in the GitHub, make sure you can follow. We have some social media pages, make sure you can follow to get the latest notification. Let's back to our main topic, like what is portal and how you can easy way to develop, right? So let's say this is the portal feature. When you visit the slash my controller, it will open something like this, which is called the portal feature provided by Odoo, and a portal module is available in the community version. And almost all the portal related templates, controller and many features available in the portal related module, and we will try to extend as much as possible, right, with minimum code. And here for example, if you want to access the Odoo with your end customers, right, they can see own data especially, so you can have a like portal feature. And so this is the backend feature, and it's only accessible by your company's employee. All right, here I try to explain how you can create a new menu like this. You can see this is the student's menu I already created. When you go to here, you can see the list view also available. And when you visit the any of the record, it will open the simple form view, right? This is the main thing. Here we have to understand the breadcrumb, this home tag, right? This is the main menu. After that, how you can add dynamic data in the tabular format in the list view, how you can search or sorting features you can implement, how you can also implement the pagination system like this. And especially when you open this form view, you can also implement here the dynamic pagination to redirect to one record to another record, right? So this is the basic things which you can see in our upcoming sessions, right, one by one how you can develop with the easy steps. Here you can see, like let's say the quotation or the let's sales order is here, right? And when you click to here, you can see you can do, you can perform many things. Let's say you can see here list of the products which you ordered for this current user. You can print, you can download the report, you can see here the dynamic image, the name and everything, including the chatter part also here, right? Plus if you want to switch to another sales order, you can directly switch like this way. Plus you can also maintain like this. Another thing is you can extend as much, let's say the bootstrap classes you can add, how you can implement such design and all. Everything is cover in upcoming sessions. Please check one by one to clear what is portal and how you can develop portal related stuff. So if you have any doubt related this topic, please comment below, and see you in next session.